China is leading the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. The USA has the most number of medals, but China has the most number of gold medals, which is the reason it is currently standing at number 1 in Tokyo 2020 Olympics. Do you know, back in 1932 Olympics, China participated with only one contestant, and that too didn't secure any medals. But how did the same country now become number 1 country with most gold medals? Well, it's China. It can go up to any extent to prove its dominance in any field, whether it's trade, war, or sports. It is even using ballistic missile technology in training its athletes, which I'll be telling you in a bit, and it's quite interesting. Besides this, there are a lot of harsh stories, sacrifices, and even shocking practices behind these shiny gold medals. Welcome back to another video. In this, I will explain how China is winning the Olympics. The Olympics is a global event, and the only event where we get to see the world-class performance by world-class athletes on one big stage. It is considered as a prestigious event more than a sports event, as many countries use Olympic Games to exhibit their global dominance. A lot of countries and their governments offer millions of dollars and prestigious awards to their athletes as an encouragement to achieve gold medals.
Fueled by their passion, sustained by their greatness.
But China doesn't do this. It rather uses another approach, force. Everything happens in the training camps. Seeing the kids here, whether they like it or not, these kids are relentlessly trained for hours daily. Little children at a very young age are taken away from their parents. They don't have education, normal childhood, or a social life. They never see any toys, books, schools, or any of the outside world. They are fed, motivated, and trained like machines, and their lives serve only one purpose: Olympics. Things get much worse from here. After the years of intensive training, if any candidate suffers any physical injury, or he may be just inefficient or not capable of getting a gold medal, then they will be forcibly taken out of their training. Once they are out, they will be left with no livelihood, as they don't have any proper education or any other skills other than sports they train for. Many people were seen on streets trying to make a little livelihood out of their little skills. India's Mirabai Chanu was defeated by Chinese wrestler in 49kg women weightlifting finals. Mirabai Chanu won silver and made India proud. On the other side, Chinese weightlifter Ho Zihu won the gold. According to New York Times report, she has been on a mission to win gold medal at Olympics since her childhood. She used to be trained 6 days a week and only few days a break in any year. This has been her sacrifice for gold medal. After receiving her gold medal, she said, "China only focuses on gold medals. The silver and bronze medals are hardly taken into account in China." China predominantly focuses on those sports which are underfunded in Western countries, and also on the sports where it can get more than one gold medal. Do you think it's a coincidence? Since 1984, China's 75% of Olympic gold medals have come from only 6 sports events, which are table tennis, shooting, diving, badminton, gymnastics, and weightlifting. These are the sports in which Western countries are barely seen. More than 2/3 of China's Olympic contestants who won the gold are women. Here also the same reason. Women participants are very less in Western countries when compared to their men counterparts. China observed this and took advantage of this less competition by training more women athletes to win more medals. There are a lot of controversies behind these gold medals too. According to New York Times report, a former Chinese national champion was so impoverished after her retirement, and also she was seen with beard, which she said that it is the result of doping forced upon her when she is younger. What is doping? Doping is nothing but use of prohibited medications, drugs, or any treatments on athletes to improve their performance. This is strictly unethical and illegal. According to Guardian report, former China's Olympic doctor Xu Xuan revealed that China has done systematic doping in more than 10,000 athletes during the 1980s and 1990s. After, this Chinese whistleblower doctor flew to Germany for her life. She also claimed that China even involved little kids in doping, and the one who refuses doping has to leave the sports. She was dismissed when she refused to administer an athlete with the prohibited drugs. According to her, the medals of 80s and 90s should be withdrawn from China. During the 2008 Beijing Olympics, 4 Chinese women gold winners were re-examined and found guilty of doping. all the four medals were revoked. We cannot conclude that every medal that is won by China and its athletes is because of all these reasons. There are instances where China used innovative methods to train its athletes. It used ballistic missile tunnels, where the wind is blown against the athlete. These conditions make the athlete to overcome the wind barriers more effectively than the other candidates. This can be the other reason why Chinese athletes were performing much better than the rest. There may be several controversies, but we have to respect every nation and its athlete who worked hard and stood on top. I think what's much needed is countries should stop seeing Olympics as a prestigious event to prove their dominance. Rather, Olympics should be seen as a healthy and inclusive sports event between countries of the world. Sports are meant to be fun, and that's how they should be. Both the players and spectators should feel the fun in the Olympics, rather than crushing the players and sport itself with the force of geopolitics. That's pretty much it. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up by hitting the like button down below the video. And there is also a video coming in which I'll be talking about how India can excel in next coming Olympics. It's going to be an awesome video, so hit that subscribe button to not miss the video. And don't forget to press that bell icon. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Till then, stay curious, stay logical. Peace.